This is going to sound really crazy. We call people who buy our info products.
Hey, podcast listener. You're about to discover insider tips, tricks, and secrets to making more sales and converting more prospects into customers with email marketing. For more information about the Email Marketing Podcast or the Autoresponder Guy, go to dropdeadcopy.com/podcast. Hey everybody, it's John McIntyre here, the Autoresponder Guy, and it's time for episode 15 of the Email Marketing Podcast, where we talk about the top tips, tricks, and secrets for making more sales and growing your revenue with email marketing. But I got a surprise today. I'm going to be talking to Greg Rollett. Now, Greg used to be a white rapper in a rock band. And the reason I brought him on is because I want to talk, I'm basically changing this podcast to a podcast about white rappers, rock bands, and music. So I hope you're okay with that. One opportunity. Yeah, right, just kidding. But as you'll hear in a second, Greg really was a white rapper in a rock band. But these days, he is the owner of Celebrity Expert Marketing, where he helps entrepreneurs position themselves as the expert, celebrity, and leader of their industry. They do done-for-you Dan Kennedy-style marketing. So they show you how to do it yourself, or they can do it for you, which is really cool. Now, in this episode, we talk about why 60 to 70% of the money is in the follow-up and share some old-school direct response tactics for follow-up sequences. Now, this is relevant to local practices, to email marketers, to everyone who has a business across the board, okay? Or autoresponders, or the concept there is that you're following up with someone. And the concept of following up with someone and the benefits of it is not new at all. So, you know, we specifically talk about if you're a lawyer, or if you're a chiropractor, and you're throwing an event and you're bringing 30 people into that event, how should you be following up with them before the event and after? And according to Greg, this can double your business virtually overnight if you start, you know, implementing this. And that's a lot of money, especially if you're, say, a financial advisor and you're taking 15, 20, 30 grand commissions, okay? So it's going to be relevant to email marketers and local practices. Now, to get the show notes for this episode of the Email Marketing Podcast, go to dropdeadcopy.com/EP15. Now, we just did the McIntyre Method launch over the last week, and I sold it out. Now, the McIntyre Method is it's my four-week program for how to create autoresponders based on how I've been working with different companies around the world to do it. It's usually a 5 or 10 email autoresponder sequence. By the end of the program, that's what you're meant to have. It's very step-by-step. It's very strategic and tactical, and I designed it to really help you get shit done, basically, to sit down and actually write the damn emails. It's sold out at the moment, but if you want to hear about it next time when it launches, which will be within the next few months, probably, go to dropdeadcopy.com/podcast, and you'll receive the launch emails next time. Now, in the meantime, let's go talk to Greg Rollett about follow-up sequences. It's John McIntyre here, the Autoresponder Guy. I'm here with Greg Rollett, a best-selling expert of celebrity expert marketing. Greg, how are you going today?
What's happening, man?
Thanks for coming on, man. Let's start. We'll get into some follow-up in a minute about how the money is in the follow-up and how 60 to 70% of your business can actually come from the follow-up. And now this is for professional practice marketing, so accountants, lawyers, financial guys, chiropractors, that type of thing. So we've got some real bit of a different kind of episode today. But let's start, Greg. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, definitely. So I am a former white rapper in a rock band. That's kind of my first claim to fame. I was fortunate enough, I toured the country here in the United States, everywhere from Madison Square Garden in New York City, where the Knicks play, all the way out to the Knitting Factory on Hollywood Boulevard in LA, and everything in between. And when that kind of career started to transition and started to grow up, I guess, a little, I started having companies just start contacting me to say, hey, all that stuff that you were doing for your band, to help promote yourself, can you do that for us? And I thought it was really cool. I started consulting on digital marketing for Coca-Cola, for Miller Lite, for Warner Brothers, and all these big companies. And so I started my first agency, and it was just internet marketing stuff. And things kind of spiraled from there. And over the last few years, I have started two companies that I run now. One is called The Product Pros, where we help people develop information-based products. And it's a lot of untraditional info product guys. So we're not in the make money online space. We are creating, as you said, like professional practice guys. We're creating products for them. So a chiropractor who wants a 12 CD program on, you know, overall lifestyle and wellness tips, the financial advisor creating a DVD series on, you know, how to protect your retirement nest egg, things like that. And that logically led into some marketing services that these guys wanted. And we're big Dan Kennedy guys. And what we do is a lot of done for you Dan Kennedy style marketing. So we're going to talk a lot about the follow-up stuff today, but we're very big on hitting people both with direct mail and some email, hitting people up with physical shock and awe boxes. I mean, we spend more money with FedEx than anyone should humanly spend with FedEx. You know, but hitting up people, you know, do a lot of shock and awe boxes. We send a lot of physical CDs, DVDs, special reports, catalogs, mailers. But we're also at the same time hitting them up with corresponding emails that correspond with the physical stuff. So we're getting them really to multi-touch, multimedia, and it just enhances the experience. And as we're going to talk about, I mean, it is driving so much business for these guys. It's insane. So that's the Cliff Notes story, and obviously we'll talk a little bit more about that as we go.
Cool, man. I had no idea you were a white rapper.
Yeah, it's kind of nuts. It's still on the good old iTunes. That stuff just never seems to disappear. But
nice, man. What was the name? What was the name of the band?
My name was Giro, so Greg Rillette, Giro. And then the band was called Stump, S-T-U-M-P-P. It was hurricane season here in Florida, and right after the hurricanes left, there was all these signs that said Stump Grinding. To take like the stumps from the trees that had fallen over from the hurricane. And we were drunk and thought that would have been a really cool name for the band. So that's the quick band name story.
That's badass, man. Okay, cool. Let's get into this. So tell me a bit about the follow-up, how it works, why it's important, that kind of thing.
Yeah, so dealing with our guys, what we really want to do, so the name of the company, obviously, Celebrity Expert Marketing, is in all the communication that we send, we want to position our guys as the celebrity expert in their marketplace. We want them to be the trusted advisor. We want them to not just be this guy selling financial products, like I'm going to sell you life insurance or a 401k plan or whatever crap they're selling. We want them to be these financial rock stars that like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm meeting with this guy. Not that he's going to sell me, but he's got great information, that he's a trusted expert. And so all the communication that we send has to position him as that type of guy. It's very conversational, it's going back to the guru expert-ish type of speak that you get from the big name guys. We're just using that same speak in these professional practices, and it's really cool how we do it. And so the first thing is, before you even meet with the people, we want to be sending out those types of communications. So for a lot of, let's use like a financial advisor as an example. A lot of financial advisors throw these dinner seminars where they send out a bunch of invitations in the mail and or email. They buy lists, however the case is, and they try to get people to come to a nice steakhouse. It's old people. They try to get old people in a room and buy them a nice, you know, $50 steak, and then talk to them about, you know, their retirement plans, whatever it is, and they try to convert them into consultations, right? So the example I always give is they get 30 people in a room. Is usually their goal, 30 to 40 people. So, John, I sent you an invitation. John, you reply to that and you RSVP that you're going to show up. Now, from the moment that you RSVP, I am hitting your inbox and your mailbox with communication that's going to position myself as this celebrity expert type person. So I'm emailing you, hey, John, you know, thanks for RSVPing for the event. Can't wait till you get there. Before you get there, I'd love it if you could check out this video. I was actually just featured on an interview on ABC News the other day. I'd love for you to check it out before you come. You know, and so you're getting that in your email right away. So it's the positioning of, you know, you're not just going to get sold some stuff. You're actually seeing a TV star, right? And then in the mail at the same time, we're hitting you up with a kit that comes FedEx. It comes the next day. And it's, you know, a special report of the 10 things you need to ask your financial advisor about your retirement, along with a letter, along with directions, along with, you know, all this stuff. And that goes on for 2, 3, 4, 5 days, depending on how far in advance you RSVP for the event. So before you even show up, you've been hit with all these different pieces of medium, you know, you're hitting up with emails, and now you're stoked, you're excited to see this guy. You know, so when you come into the room, you come into the steakhouse, you know, John, you come up and you're like, holy crap, that's Greg. I can't believe this is the same guy that I just saw on TV and that I saw, he sent me a copy of his book. And, you know, it really just gets people excited. And that's just before they even get into the room. It just goes to show the importance that you can build a case for somebody in a very short time frame by the words and by the excitement and the positioning that you put in these messages.
Okay. Fantastic. So you're doing that all initially before the game. So you're doing this via email and direct mail, right?
Correct.
Would you do this on a daily basis or a weekly, or does it just depend?
Yeah. So it depends on how far in advance we can get people to, you know, so like online, right? So if I'm doing a webinar, I'm usually only sending those emails out a few days before the webinar. I'm not sending them out like a month before the webinar starts, right? So from the internet standpoint, you know, you only have a short time frame, right? So Rich Sheffrin is like a genius at this. He like makes people register like 2 to 3 days before they can show up to this thing. So he can send you his business manifesto, and he can send you this other thing. And again, it positions him before you jump on the webinar, but you only have a short time frame. You only got 2 days. With these offline guys, with the chiropractors that we have, with the financial advisors, with some of the plastic surgeons, when they're having these events, we sometimes have 2-3 weeks before the event. So it allows us a lot more time to play. Okay. Right. So what I like to do is immediately we FedEx something overnight in the mail, right? Because everybody in the entire world, it's really easy just to send an email saying, hey, thanks. You know, here's the time and date, make sure you show up, email, right? Which you should do. But everyone can do that. There's not many guys that are going to spend the $20 to overnight something to you to show up to your doorstep, right? So just by taking that step, it positions us as, holy shit, John just sent me a FedEx pack overnight just because I registered for this stupid dinner seminar. So now, again, it changes the perception and the framing in their mind. But now I have 2 weeks before the event that I can pepper them with, you know, again, that thank you email. I can pepper them with something that goes to a video. I can pepper them with a couple other emails of articles I've written for sites or blog posts or podcasts or whatever the case is. So what we like to do is not hit them every day. For the professional practice guys, we're doing every 2 to 3 days before the event. Now on the internet side, it's a lot different because there's a shorter time gap. With these professional practice guys, we have a much larger time gap. And also the people that we're going after, we go after a very affluent crowd with these guys. So with the financial advisors, I mean, we're looking for people that have investable assets of like 500 grand plus. So these are busy people, they're wealthy people, they have a lot going on. And so if they register for something 2 weeks or further out, it's the last thing from their mind. And we need to make it very top of mind in order for them to commit to showing up. Right? Because if we get 35, 40 RSVPs, I want 35 to 40 people to show up, not 5 to 10 people to show up. Okay. So having that type of communication allows more the stick rate to really improve.
So that's really cool. So just quickly, let's talk. I mean, how would a professional practice person who's listening to this, how would they have one of these events? Are they having a dinner? Is it like a speaking event or a seminar? Right? What are some ways someone could do that?
Yeah, definitely. So the financial advisor, the typical model is doing the steak dinners. And when they do the steak dinner, there's usually a 30-minute presentation or so before dinner starts. So you got to sit through the presentation before you get your food, essentially. and then it allows the financial advisor to go around and talk to people during dinner. With chiropractors, we've done a lot of in-office events, a lot of things. I mean, in today's age, I mean, if you are a professional practice guy, you should really think about publishing a book of some sort. So having book signings in the office are a really good thing to do. Quarterly reviews, quarterly health wellness reviews. So coming in and everybody comes in for like some kind of group health assessment, bringing in guest speakers. We have a lot of guys now here in the States doing wine tastings. So they'll go to like a country club or a resort or something of that nature, and they'll invite all their clients out and they'll say, all clients bring a friend, and they'll do like a wine tasting. So all of those types of events, whatever excuse you can create to get people in a room together, you know, works really, really well. And again, I mean, you could, and we have other guys, I mean, it doesn't have to be event driven. So we have a lot of financial guys right now who, you know, we're just sending out a lot of pieces that just say, you know, hey, we want to give you a copy of our free book in order to come in for a consultation. So they're not actually going to an event, like a group event. They're just coming into the office for a consultation. But the same thing applies, that you want to position yourself as the guy before that consultation. You don't want someone coming into a consultation dry, right? You want them to know who you are. You want them to know the lingo. You want them you want to kind of indoctrinate them on your process. I mean, it's a lot of what you talk about with the autoresponders, all right? When someone goes to a website and they enter their name and email address, you know, for some type of free thing, you want to indoctrinate them into your culture and your way of thinking before you present the product. Because if you present the product too fast, they don't know why they need it. They don't know their problem yet. They don't know, you know, they don't know enough education yet. So this process is really important in a positioning standpoint.
Okay, so what's really interesting here is you're taking like the standard autoresponder model, which a lot of people are aware of because they listen to this, and then you're applying that, or you know, it's probably going the other way around, really, in the big picture. But basically, applying the same stuff that people do to email marketing and autoresponders, you're using those same principles with direct mail and applying it in a very specific situation when you need to position someone as the expert for some sort of event or meetup, that kind of thing.
Oh, heck yeah, man. It's the same concept, same principles as that you teach in your program and that you teach on the podcast. It is that same methodology, and it's really about those touch points, and it's about positioning, and it's about making people believe in you before they actually meet you, because it's really, really powerful. I mean, so something that we did internally in our own business is when someone actually becomes a client of the Product Pros, which is our product creation business, we weren't really doing anything. So we actually do done-for-you product creation. So that means I got to get on the phone with you, do a consultation, figure out what your market is, what are the things you want to cover, how do you help people, and then I got to create a product basically for you about your marketplace. And these initial consultations, they were taking, you know, I was hoping in my head that they would take about 30 minutes. They started taking 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, because I had to go through this entire process and they had no idea. Well, now we have an autoresponder and direct mail sequence for customers when they become clients, that they get a package FedEx to them overnight that talks about, you know, the four things that must be included in every information product. They get a copy of our information product that we give them for free. And in that, we send another direct piece that says you have to go through module one before your scheduled consultation with Greg. And now when they get on the phone, they're like, oh, we know what a framework is, and we were brainstorming that, and we know exactly what our market's problem is. And this, now my calls went from 3 hours to 30 minutes because they know the language, they know what to expect. Very upfront, I say, hey, this call is going to last 30 minutes. This is the goal in the call. But you have to send those messages to them to pre-frame them on what you want to accomplish, pre-frame them on the lingo. I mean, I'd spend 30 minutes just explaining what a framework is, you know, and, right. And to me, that's common nature. But to some, you know, financial advisor, like, I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. So that process, it doesn't matter what business you're in. You have to get people to buy into your philosophy, into your terminology, and into your positioning.
Fantastic. So we've positioned, you know, you as an expert before the event, and then you go to the event, you meet people, and you give them the talk, you eat some steak, you talk to the people. What happens afterwards?
So this is the biggest mistake and the biggest opportunity for professional practice guys and even online guys, because what they do, so I'll use the example of the financial advisor again. They get 30 people in a room and they feed them steaks and they get about 15 of them to commit to that secondary appointment, which is great, right? I got 15 new prospects coming in for a one-on-one appointment, but there's 15 people that didn't say yes. There's 15 people that, you know, are like, tonight's not the night, or I'm not going to sign up. And these financial guys, when we were going into their business, were literally just throwing those 15 leads away. And then next month, they would re-mail and get another group of 30 people in. They close half of them, and they throw the other half away. And I was like, holy shit. Like, after a year, and I can't do math on the fly, but let's say they're doing one event a month, right? And so they're getting 15, they're throwing 15 leads away 12 times a year. I mean, that's 150, 175 people that took time out of their day to come and hang out with you for 2 hours, right? There's some level of interest there. Like, maybe they were having a bad day, or maybe they needed to talk to their spouse, or, you know, maybe they just weren't ready. I mean, I have people, we just had someone sign up for our service yesterday that's been on our list for 2.5 years and just finally bought our product and service. It's because we hammer on them all the time. We're still communicating with them. So the money, most of the time, is in the follow-up. And this happens, I was at a Dan Kennedy, we're in his mastermind group, and you know, he was talking about all these online guys, and they spend all this money on advertising to get people on a webinar, whether it's through a joint venture, whether it's through Facebook ads, Google ads, whatever the case is, they get a shitload of people on this webinar. And they do the webinar, they make sales, yeah, good for them, and then they send 2 replay emails, right, to the 99% of people that didn't buy. And that's it. Then they're done. They sent 2 replay emails like, hey, John, we had a great webinar yesterday. Check out the replay here. And then the next day they send one more. Hey, John, if you haven't seen it yet, click here. And I was like, holy shit, we're doing that too. But we were spending all this money. Some guys, I mean, we were writing 10, 15 emails to get people onto a webinar We got them to the webinar and we'd send them two messages afterwards. Hmm. It's just insane that the money is in the follow-up and you don't think about it. And that's what these financial guys were doing as well, is they would spend all this money. And we're talking direct mail to like 10 to 15,000 people to get 30 to 40 at an event. And they get the 30 people there. So they're spending a crap load of money to get the people at this seminar. They close some and they literally throw the 15 away. So we were like, all right, well, what if we just, now we only got 15 guys. We only got to send 15 guys some stuff. So can we send them some good stuff, right? So there's only 15 of them, right? So if we spend $5 on each of them, that's only $45, right? I can't do math, so I might be off, but whatever. It's not a lot of money to send 15 guys a $5 package in the mail, right? And then we send them an email. It costs virtually nothing to send them an email. And then can I create a phone script so their phone team would hit them up too? Like, hey, John, you know, saw you were at the seminar the other night. Wanted to make sure that you got the package that we sent you. We know it's not, you know that situation is the best for everyone, but sometimes it's great if you come in for a one-on-one. And out of those 15 that they were just throwing away, we were getting now 5, 6, 7, 10 of them into the office afterwards, and almost doubling revenue overnight by just implementing simple follow-up systems to guys that were interested, but just they just needed a little something else to get them over the edge. It's freaking nuts.
That's insane, man. Okay, so it actually works. Since you got 5, 6, 10, you know, 10 people coming back. You said you're doubling someone's business just by implementing a proper follow-up sequence.
Yeah, it's really, really crazy. And so with these financial advisors, luckily we're dealing with big ticket guys, right? So like I said earlier, we're dealing with very affluent clients. And if they're bringing in $500,000 to invest, to put that investment under management, I mean, you're looking at a $20,000 to $30,000 commission for the financial advisor.
Okay.
Right. So if you're looking at that big of a commission, are you willing to spend a couple bucks to send out a $5 package? You know, and that's the rationale that we pitched to them. I mean, you know, they pay for my services in one client, two clients for an entire year. So, you know, it's really cool when you're dealing with that. I mean, same thing with like plastic surgeons. When you're dealing with surgery that's $5,000, $10,000, $15,000, you have a lot more room to play for some of this direct mail stuff. But it doesn't mean that if you don't have that big of margins that you can't be doing the same stuff that you teach with the email stuff and just have a triggered sequence that goes out to these people. And then, you know, have different sequences for different things. So just like I said earlier, we implemented a sequence just for our actual customers. So out of the, let's say, now let's go back to the 15 that did commit to an appointment, right, at this event. The 15 that did raise their hand and say, yes, I want an appointment. Well, they weren't really sending anything to those 15 guys. And they were wondering why only 6 or 7 would actually show up for the consultation. And I was like, well, you didn't send them any reminders. You know, you didn't even send them an email saying, you know, hey, John, thanks for signing up for a date. We can't wait to see you in the office at this time and date. And so you have to have all of these different, and it sounds like a freaking lot of work, but you do it once and you can really run with it, which is really the fun part, is it's a lot of work up front and then it's a lot of automation on the back end, which is, I'm sure, a lot of what you talk about as well. So setting up the different things for the customers to make sure that they show up to the appointment. But then you got the people that show up to the appointment, and then you have certain people that buy and sign over all their money, and you have some people that don't, right? So, you know, same thing. It goes to any business. So a dentist, right? A dentist runs some kind of ad for a teeth cleaning, and he gets a certain number of people that come into the office and do the $29 teeth cleaning, and then they're upsold some type of other package. Like, you know, your teeth are jacked up, so you need some kind of, you know, cosmetic dentistry, whatever it is. A certain number of people are going to say, yes, I want the cosmetic whatever dentistry stuff, and you're going to have a larger percentage that say no. Well, are you following up with all those people that said no? And then also, are you following up with the people that said yes to prepare them for the surgery, to give them education, to give them testimonials, to send them videos of, you know, before and after photos of people who had jacked up teeth just like yours, and now what it looks like afterwards. I mean, you've got to have those different pieces because, you know, it really helps in all phases of the business to continue to just make people believe that you're the guy, that you're the person that can really get them the results that they desire.
The reason I think this is so cool is it just, it brings home the importance of following up with people, because people are lazy. They forget about this stuff. They're not going to remember when the appointments are. But when you follow up, it can change the entire game and it can bring so much more money in. Most people aren't doing this. It's insane.
It is insane. And it's really crazy So I don't understand it, but I understand that people don't follow up with sometimes unconverted leads for a certain period of time, because at some point you're like, all right, they're tire kickers. The really interesting thing is that people don't follow up with their actual customers and the people that gave them money, because those are the best people to refer, right? Those are the best people to sing your praises. Those are the people that you want actually consuming the products or services or whatever it is that you have. And so they're not sending out welcome kits. They're not sending out emails saying, hey, you just bought my product. Here's actually what to do with the thing that you just bought, and then reinforcing the message over time saying, you know, hey, you should be in module, you know, for internet guys, you should be on module one right now. If you're not in module one, here's what you need to do. Or, you know, if you haven't, and it's just crazy the things that, the little things that you can do. Another thing that we implemented on our info products, and this is going to sound really crazy, is that we call people who buy our info products to make sure that they got their username and their password. Stupid, simple, but that quick call is being like, hey, John, we saw that you bought the Info Product Pro the other day or yesterday. And, you know, Greg just wanted to make sure that we got you a call to make sure, did you get your username and password? Were you able to log in? And they say yes, or they say no. They say yes. We say, all right, you know, did you check out the intro video that, that Greg welcomed you to the thing and showed you where all the tabs and all that stuff were? And they say, yeah, yeah. And we ask them if there's any questions. And then about a third of those calls, at some point, someone just goes, you know, can Greg just do all this crap for me? And it turns into an upsell. So we were just, we were literally just calling to make sure that they got their username and password and be good guys. And it leads into a conversation of us doing coaching, us doing the done for you. And it's crazy talk, because people sell products online, so they don't have to do that. But it's, again, it's lost revenue. And then the people that don't even bite on the upsells, which is totally cool, they now are tweeting saying, oh my God, I can't believe I just got a call from Greg and his team about this product I bought. You know, they leave great reviews. They give us testimonials. They're more responsive to offers that we send down the road, because they know that we're real people. We didn't just leave them behind. And it doesn't matter who you are or what you're doing. If you're a dentist, you should be sending thank you cards to the people that you just clean their teeth, right? It costs you a dollar with like send out cards being like, hey, John, thanks for coming in, getting your teeth cleaned yesterday. We can't wait. It sounds so common sense, but it's not common practice.
Okay. And it works.
And it works. That's the crazier part.
All right, man. Cool. We're coming up just on time right now. So it sounds like the big lesson from this episode is that everyone should be following up. And the more they make from a sale, the more they should spend on follow-up with events and direct mail and that type of thing.
100%.
Fantastic, man. Well, before we wrap up, give yourself a plug to tell me where they can find you, more about this celebrity expert stuff, and then we'll say goodbye.
Definitely, man. Yeah, you can check out celebrityexpertmarketing.com. You can also look for the Celebrity Branding You podcast on iTunes. And obviously, we do all of this stuff for our clients. And it's a heck of a good time. And love to chat more, and definitely leave comments over on John's site with any questions about anything we talked about. And I'll be sure to answer them as well.
Cool. All right, man. Those links will be down in the show notes. And yeah, thanks again, Greg.
Awesome, man. Appreciate it.
Hey, everybody, thanks for listening. If you want to discover more insider tips, tricks, and secrets about driving sales with email marketing, sign up for daily email tips from the Autoresponder Guy. Go to dropdeadcopy.com/podcast. Sign up, confirm your email address, and I'll send you daily emails on how to improve your email marketing and make more sales via email. You'll find out why open rates don't matter, and the seven-letter word that underlies all effective marketing, and much more.